Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Blood Bowl 2. Once again, we're here to play in the Dead Air Invitational. It's me, my Full Metal Munchies, against Mr. Noximus. How are you doing, sir?
Hello. I'm doing good. How are you doing?
Well, I'm looking forward to getting both downed in the face every match today. So
I look forward to that happening to you as well.
Yeah, well, I've got 100... No, I'm missing a Beastman, so I get that, but I'll probably be able to get a Babe, I imagine. Because I missed Wrap Up this week, so I didn't work out any of the actual things.
Yeah, I believe we worked out that you got a Babe. That's it.
What are you missing?
That's definitely Babe. Just a Beastman. Bow, bow, bow now, bow, bow now, bow, bow now.
It's all right. I've got my super dwarf now.
Super dwarf. Oh yeah, you're
strength.
I've got my super chaos warrior.
It's true.
What's your super chaos warrior?
It's a four strength
chaos warrior with four agi. He doesn't have block though.
It's true. Like the two level ups I have, one is a chaos warrior with an agility and a beastman with plus movement. Good evening,
oh
no, it's raining.
Oh god.
But we're in the cradle of Philly.
That gives you the advantage, though, Pete. That gives you the advantage because you have an IG 4 piece to attempt to pick
true.
The ball.
That is true. You realise I am just going to laugh if every level up I get now is just going to be a stat modifier.
That would make an interesting team. Like, I don't know if that team would be good. Like, they would definitely have an edge because of those stats, but no skills would be...
There would be a point at which you want to start taking skills.
Yeah.
And I imagine it would be quite early.
Maybe.
I've done alright on stats. I haven't done any strength, but I've got a plus agi blitzer and a plus movements go runner, which is amazing.
I think I literally took like 4 blocks. I got like 5 or 6 level ups this week and I took like 4 or 5 blocks.
Oh. Right, coin flip's gone and I am doing the first drive.
There's the guard piece.
There we go, man.
Guy, there he is. Alright. So you do have...
Should I talk about Norse during setup, then?
Yeah, you might as well.
Sure.
It's going to
take...
Sure, so on Cyanide's site, they posted the first like preview of the Norse team. It should be coming very soon. So if you want to go and see that, you can like literally go on bloodbowl-game.com and go check out the news post. They're pretty cool. They've gone with the very stereotypical Viking look.
Well, it's not that far changed from what they were.
No, I know. I don't know. I'd say I think it's just the graphic style of Blood Bowl 2. They're definitely more cartoony Viking in this, but that's not a bad thing. I'm not meaning this is like a criticism.
Their warriors look more like Amazons. I'll be fair, with the long flowing ginger hair.
That's what they kind of looked like in Blood Bowl.
Just comment on that.
The hair was less colorful though.
Yeah.
But then again, in general, Blood Bowl 1 is not colourful at all.
I'd say that, and I'm not sure how much of a reference this is going to be to the rest of you, but I'd say in Blood Bowl 1, they looked more akin to Vrykul from Warcraft.
So I'm looking based on the thing. So obviously the thing in the middle is the Yeti or Snow Troll. And then I'm assuming the guys on the line with the... they have like a bigger shoulder pad. I'm going to assume those are the berserkers. The guys with the white hair, I'm assuming are runners. And then everyone else is the linemen, which means we don't know what the werewolves look like.
Hello, what's been going on?
It's a match happening.
Yay, awesome.
Just not the scheduled match.
Well, it is the scheduled match. It just... It's one of the
it
two
was scheduled 2 hours early. Hastily. It was scheduled right now.
No, it was scheduled before. It was scheduled like yesterday, wasn't it?
Yeah. It's 2 hours early. I think my stream's all fucked up.
Okay. We'll see how that setup goes. I'm not entirely too impressed with that, but we'll see.
So you've got rain and you're receiving the ball, but you do have AG4. And there's cheering fans. So that's
re-roll.
A good start. That's reroll. Oh, you almost had a touch.
I was really hoping that was going to get her outwards. That's the worst kick in the universe.
That's pretty bad.
No, that's a fantastic.
Could have been one more down.
Well, yeah, for you it's fantastic.
Is it a turnover if the ball goes out and then lands on one of your players when it comes back in?
Uh, desperate. No. See some
shred. How would it land on the player if it goes out?
He's talking about in normal play when as soon as
like if you went to pick up and it scattered off the pitch when you failed to pick up.
Oh, when you failed. Yeah, yeah, no. If you failed to pick it up, it's a turnover.
All right.
Oh, there's the first goal push of the game.
Although, I'll be honest, if you fail to pick it up and then someone else, like another member of your team catches it, I'm going to say I think it's a turnover, but I wouldn't know for sure.
So just that's, because I'm that's pretty... a 4+.
Which one? Oh, to pick up.
Yeah, with the mine, with the...
That's also your loner.
With the beastman, yeah, I know. Well, it doesn't really matter. None of the other beastmen have got skills. And the Chaos
Warrior. Yeah,
the
plus... but I mean, like, you could... Reroll.
On the plus side, you don't need to worry about the dwarf sprinting through and stealing it.
That's true.
Actually, that is a good point that Greg just made that I didn't think of.
You're welcome. Help me.
Did you actually put your super dwarf on the line?
Yeah. He got pushed.
I don't know why you would do that.
Yeah, neither did I. That's why I put the line in there.
Strong.
Mm. I know he's strong, but I don't. I know. I feel like people put their valuable pieces on the line way too much in this league. It's like why? What? In your drive, it makes sense because you're going to hit first. But yeah. When you're being hit first, why would you put valuable things? Nice. It's
harder to hit.
I put the Mino there because the Mino actually requires serious resources to bring out.
Yeah, big guys like big guys. I'm more lenient to, but I still think there's definitely.
Yeah, everything else is a 0 SPP line.
Yeah, there's definitely situations, even so, where I'd argue you don't want your big guy in the line, though. But yeah, generally, it's fine.
Oh, yeah.
I'd say to come on. Does Lincoln Popstars like... not really know what he's doing? Is he just kind of staggering around the pitch?
No, what it was is I was working out some sort of elf cage, but I'm trying to put my pieces in a position where if he chooses to blitz forward on the right side, that is at the edge of his...
about the turnover.
Yeah, no, I know. It's at the edge of his go for it line, so he has to still go for it in order to punch this line with the ball. Which is probably the wrong thing, because he's probably just going to get up in the front. I don't really know how to play against dwarves other than like
exploit the speed difference.
Well, yeah, I know. That's what.
That's literally it.
Spearhead.
Yeah, that's it. You're probably not gonna win a punch out battle with him.
No, not against those skills.
Not with the fact they have block on everything.
That's not true. One run, though.
There's only one runner.
Yeah, that runner has
right. one runner with it.
There's only one runner left without block now, Madden.
Yeah, like, so much block.
What you need to do is...
big people is like AV8 normally.
Pete, what you need to do is start getting level ups and just start taking rest on everything and just be like, fuck your block.
if only I had a billion games until I think, oh, wait.
But yeah. You played Bretts and you could have 4 wrestles off the mark.
That's true.
I could get, if I get really lucky with passes, I could get 3 wrestles after this game.
I don't think they'd be too smart at this
point.
Probably
taking 3 blocks would probably be best.
No, yeah. I would go 2.
Who have I got next?
I don't know who you've got next.
No, I'm facing you last, aren't I, Josh? So I've got Lucas.
Yeah. Oh, so must be Lucas.
Yeah, I think so.
Good job, Greg. Skull pushed each other.
I have Greg next week, so I would highly hope you don't feed him too much more SPP.
Too much more? I haven't fed him any yet.
No, I know, but I'm not saying you have. I'm saying everyone else has.
Barely.
I gave him 5.
I mean, yeah, like, I only gave him 10. I mean, admittedly, that all went on one guy.
Yeah, like, but all I'm saying is I don't want Greg's dwarfs to get more SVP because I'm playing him next week. Sue me. I'm not going to apologize for that comment.
Yeah, that's fair.
Oh,
that's the niggle. Oh, that's the niggle.
It's just a sum.
It might be in a KO, though, like a potential swap. No, it wasn't. It was just double T. See, I don't like the fact that doesn't show the niggle's been added.
Yeah, like, should show the dice and then plus something.
I hate it about Mighty Blow as well, where like Mighty Blow doesn't show up either.
It does occasionally pop up above the guy using it.
But it doesn't tell you whether it added Mighty Blow into the armor or the injury, because you do one or the other.
Ooh. Only the dice.
How does it add one to the injury anyway? Because the injury roll is weird. Which one does it add one to?
We worked this out the other day. It's after, like, you roll for the armor break and then it's an injury roll, and then if you... Another pass.
Oh, that isn't my badge. Really?
Yeah, you have the injury roll and then you have a casualty roll.
So it adds one to the 2d6 that determines stun, KO,
or injury.
Yeah. Just like a Nagel also adds plus one to that 2d6.
So is that that's a plus two if you're mighty blowing a Nagel injury?
Correct. Well, as long as the mighty blow doesn't get used on the armor break, but we don't know if that's going to happen because Blood Bowl doesn't tell you.
Yeah.
Well, you break armor, and then the mighty blow affects the injury roll.
No, but if you use mighty blow on the armor break roll, you don't get it on the injury. You get it on either you either get it added to breaking armor or to injury roll.
Really?
One or the other.
I thought it only applies on the actual injury roll.
No, check it. It applies to either breaking armor or add one to any armor or injury roll made by a player with this skill.
So basically,
how would that actually work in real terms? Like, if you're would you roll armor or would you announce before you roll for the armor?
No, you roll the armor, and then if you need the plus one for the mighty blow, you add it in there. If you break it without the mighty blow, you'll add it to the injury.
So it is impossible for example, an armor check to fail without mighty blow, and then you succeed with mighty blow, but then you don't get the plus one on the injury roll.
Correct, that's how it works. They're the guys with the mohawks, and...
The orange beard.
So basically, Mighty Blow is if you fail the armor break by one, it adds one to the armor break. Otherwise, it adds to the injury roll.
Correct.
Obviously, it doesn't get added if it doesn't break it.
Yes. Although you could choose not to use it because Blood Bowl lets you choose not to use any skills, pretty much.
Can someone do me a favor and check if my stream's actually working? Because it's like broken as shit for me for some reason.
There's another troll slam in front of your beastman, in case you didn't realize. Just if you, because there are two.
Yeah.
I just wasn't sure if you, because you weren't sure about it before, so I was just pointing out that in case you've missed that guy is a troll slam as well.
It's fine. I'm just trying to work out what blocks I'm gonna do this to. Like, honestly,
Trist, him fucking up that throw didn't even matter. Like, that didn't even get affected by the rain. That was just the beastman being bad.
Well, yeah. It was also a minor, so I didn't re-roll it.
No, yeah, that makes sense.
It's interesting that Mighty Blow applies if it's, for example, a bow down.
Yep.
Do you get SPP for that?
Yep,
you do.
You get it on attack down and both down if you cause an injury to the other person. The only thing you don't get it from, like, the only time you don't get injury SPP is if,
Fouling and dodging.
Yeah, fouling and dodging. Those are the only two, as far as I'm aware.
And go for it!
And surfing. Well, yeah.
Surfing's weird, though.
Also stab.
I love the fact that if you fail a GFI when you're blitzing, you just get punched in the face. They actually animated that. It's quite nice.
Yeah.
Well, they it's not just that you're blitzing. If you fail a GFI next to an enemy player, the enemy player will trip you up rather than you just falling over.
Yeah.
Which is kind of cool.
It's just hilarious to see a skink like punch out a Mino casually.
The first time I saw that, I was so confused because I thought, like...
The blocks happened, but I didn't get to pick anything.
It's not only that the block didn't happen. Like I thought, I was like, wait, did he have like a counter block thing?
Yeah, he has counter block. If you try and block him, you fall over.
Yeah, it's like
no dice roll just happens.
Yeah, I was just like, whoa, is this something I don't know about Blood Bowl? But apparently, that was.
No, it's just an extra animation they did.
Yeah.
Which is cool. They've added tons.
Which is really cool, but at the time I was terrified.
It's not really an extra animation, is it? They just used
it. No.
No, it
they
is.
They just added it for flavor, really.
Like, all the animations are different. I don't think it is the block animation, because they have all kinds of different animations. Like, for example, did you know if you get frenzy on someone, the frenzy block is a unique animation? It's not the same animation as a normal block for that piece.
No, because they all do a shoulder barge of some type of point, don't they?
Not Troll Slayers. Pretty sure they don't. Whatever.
Well, they always frenzy block, don't they?
That's what I mean, though.
You've never seen a normal Troll Slayer block.
Because they don't exist.
Yep.
Is there a way to make it exist?
But you said that they all make shoulder, like...
There's no skills that, like...
I didn't say that. I said they have a unique frenzy block.
Oh. Well, someone said that, and it was like, what?
Troll Slayers just punch things.
That's what I thought.
Does Fen stop frenzy, though?
Yes.
Stand firm as well.
Stand firm also stops frenzy, because you have to follow up to be able to make the block. So if you can't push them back, you don't get a second block.
The dwarves
are coming.
Oh, except the way like skills are like independent of strength. I think that's one of my favourite things about this game. Just because it's hilarious to see like a gutter runner or something with blodge take down a minotaur because it rolls double both down.
I mean, technically, like blocking is technically independent of strength. You just have to have like. You just have to somehow work out the initial strength to initiate the block, but then the results are not strength dependent at all.
Oh yeah.
God. The armor breaks are real.
Your mic quality is a bit like all over the place.
Yeah, you're a bit roboty today.
Well, nothing I can do about it.
Do I wanna do that? Don't wanna risk it.
It's a lot of doors.
Risk it for a biscuit. Oh.
That's not. Can someone check if my stream is working?
No. I can't. Someone else can. I can't.
Okay, don't worry. One of my viewers said the stream's not working, but it's Twitch's fault.
Right. Don't have to do anything about it.
So, fuck it. Nothing I can do? Fuck it.
It amuses the way, like, Josh was saying, the way to beat dwarves is abuse the movement speed advantage. I'm looking going, Chaos Warrior, move 5. Compared to 4 and 6 for the guys next to him.
Yeah but I say Chaos Warriors, I just said movement speed advantage. Which
oh yeah, no, I was just thinking, like, in terms of if he got the ball to that Chaos Warrior, could he break free? And I looked at the movement and went, not really.
No.
Plus move speed advantage doesn't necessarily mean one player.
Oh yeah, true.
It's not just a case of I run away from him at a faster speed and he can catch up. It's you can make positional moves that mean the dwarves can't catch you.
Yeah, like I did.
Exactly. Lucas's tactic against Greg worked perfectly.
Actually did the tactic.
What, the spearhead?
Yeah,
the spearhead worked perfectly. Greg pulled all his players to one side of the pitch and then Lucas just went the other side of the pitch. It's just like, oh shit, I can't actually get back across.
I didn't know
across.
What to do. I was confused.
No one has ever done that in the history of Dota.
Good pass.
It's my favorite meme.
You meant to say Dota.
I did say, I mean, it's a Dota meme.
Oh, wow.
Wow. The sheer nonchalantness of catching that ball.
Just no animation, just appears in his hand like whatever.
That was such a... Did you forget about the rain and the tackle zone?
I forgot about the tackle really zone affecting dicey the pass, not the rain.
Yeah, you sure did. The dwarves aren't very big, I mean.
I mean, yeah, the pass was a 2+, because apparently rain doesn't apply to the pass, just the catch.
Oh,
it doesn't miss catching.
You ballsy motherfucker.
Oh my
god. I like it, Pete. I'm a fan.
Yeah, I'm totally a fan of this play. This is exactly what you need to be doing.
Yep.
Well.
Come on, guys. Team spirit is the key. Well, I guess that other beastman is just staying on the ground.
He doesn't get hit.
It doesn't matter because that dwarf can't catch on. What would matter about was keeping the dwarves on the right sorted.
He could still catch up with your ball carrier, though.
Yeah, that's why I got a tackle zone, another tackle zone on the Troll Slayer. He still has to dodge out.
Yeah, but... We'll see.
Yeah, but right, you're not playing.
We'll see.
That's a lot going.
All right, I'll just shut up then.
Yeah.
Have you got eight going for it on your screen?
Three. Yeah.
Yeah. Hmm. I mean, it's going to be at least two because I think it's one. Oh shit. Okay.
No, it's only one. Yeah.
The one guy.
Oh, failed it.
I knew that was going to happen.
King
anyway.
One,
well, if I'm going to do ballsy plays, Greg has to do them as well, let's be fair.
Yeah.
Let's do.
That was pretty good, though.
That was the correct play.
That was shut up, man.
No, I'm thinking in terms of how many dwarves can actually get up the pitch.
Yeah. Because these five that are still in your half, they're kind of pretty far back. I would have thought you'd gone with the
deal for Greg right now.
I should have moved.
Was that two dice?
I should have.
He's strength four.
I shouldn't have run straight with the beastman. I should have run one to the left, and that's the thing I didn't work out properly. I don't think it would have mattered.
I don't think it would have mattered either. Maybe it would have done. But he was like, the runner was pretty centralized, wasn't he?
Yeah.
And the runner, actually, the runner's the same speed as you, so no, wouldn't have, and he was in contact with the beastman, yeah. So it wouldn't have mattered.
Oh, fucking armor breaks, man.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I needed that. I definitely needed that.
That is unfortunate.
No, unfortunately not dead.
I shouldn't have done that. I knew what I was going into, so it wasn't trapped so much as I did it.
It was frenzy trap. You could claim as much as you want it wasn't a frenzy trap, but it was a frenzy trap.
Like, that is what it was, but I like went into it knowingly. I walked into the trap. I put my foot in the bear trap.
You saw a bear trap in the middle of the street, and you drop. You did the Chaos Warrior drop kick into the trap.
I put my face.
You even like acknowledged it was a trap. You were like, "This is a trap."
This is a trap. Gosh, ow!
How did this happen? I knew it was a trap.
Yeah.
I've been prepared.
What have I done?
How could this have possibly gone wrong?
Should be good.
I'm just desperately thinking how I'm going to deal with the dwarves next week, and I honestly don't know.
Oh, nice. That's your movement 7 guy as well, so there's no GFIs.
Yeah, no, go for it.
Oh, shit, you get done with that. I was thinking you have to blitz with the guy on the ground.
No. That's why I was hoping it.
Which one will you pick?
That's why I was hoping and praying that you
didn't
do anything. This is
going to
suck.
All
right, drop it. Let's try to pick up the ball first before we do anything.
One rain. Not up to much today. Yes.
Didn't.
Fail again.
Fuck the rain, man.
Oh. Bullshit. Never lucky.
Say, Greg.
Fuck off, Greg. I mean,
you've used a reroll this time. Oh my god.
I was a smart decision. Oh, that what are you doing, you mad crazy fool?
I'll be honest, what I would have done there was stand, move the warrior with the beastman with the ball to the, center, the top left square with your other beastman. So your beastman.
Oh, no, that's really well placed, actually, because that means if
no, that is a good place, but that's way.
It
but
was
that's
really
that's
fucking out. Risky.
Oh, yeah, it was.
Yeah, what I was
first,
thinking.
I thought you were crazy, but now I've highlighted the guy on the ground, I can see why you did it.
Yeah. Which is what I was trying to do on the last turn, is try and get someone out of range of Go For It, and I think that Beastman is, which I think leaves Greg in a position to just punch dudes because he's going to try and force them to score as fast as possible.
Yeah, the what I was thinking is if you put him in, like I said, the so like if I'm in Pete's point of view, so if you put that beastman in the top left of the other beastman,
you fucking
there's one. Greg and I are both playing from this perspective, is that we have to fail again. Fail. Yes. Oh my god.
Never lucky.
That was.
To finish my point, I would have put the beastman in the top left there because that means Greg has to not only dodge to get to like blitz him, he can only blitz him with the runner, and it would be like a red dice if you put them next to each other. He doesn't even get a one dice from it.
You say top left, and I presume you mean like on the pint.
Either top left or literally to the left of the beastman currently standing up.
The thing is, to the left, he was in range of the Captain Ninebeard's blitz as well.
Like, so Greg wants to dodge out. That.
He was, but it would take going for it, and it would require, it would have required more, more risk from Greg to do it.
And I do that.
But yeah, the play Pete made was absolutely, completely valid as well. It was just riskier. the dwarf, they're playing against dwarves, aka spam clicking measurements to see how far they can be.
Absolutely.
Pretty much what it is.
Oh, that's a dwarf.
No, rough and tough Rory, no.
Which one was that, your blitzer?
No, it's just a. It's just a.
No, it was a blitzer.
It was a blitzer.
Yeah. Yep. Fair. That's good then, that's a speed piece off.
You can move even less.
I wish Bertie the Bulls was like called Santa or something, because like, look at that beard. That is a glorious Santa beard.
Which is Bertie?
The one with God.
Yeah. The armor breaks.
It's about time, you know?
It's bullshit.
Fuck off, mate. How much armor breaks did you get a couple of turns ago?
You've only got one guy out there.
The memes generated by this season so far is hashtag always last and hashtag never lucky.
Never lucky. Though in saying that, I did just steal that from Trump.
Stolen meme is still a meme.
Hit on the floor, please.
Where's the niggle troll slayer? Oh, it's that one. No, it's not. Where's... Is it?
It's this one over here.
Angry Alfred.
Oh, that's interesting. It doesn't show up on the like the like. It doesn't show up above his head in the skills.
Well, yeah, I suppose it's because they're not actually skilled.
Right. No, but it shows up on him. Like,
yeah, I guess.
I expect it to show up as well above him because it is a thing
you
should know.
Oh, what you mean on the KO?
True.
No, on the niggle, like the niggle injury, like if you click on the troll slayer, you can see he has
shit,
niggle injury.
I didn't work that one out. Must be shit.
It's not a great one though.
Well, no, but it's about the same as what you've been doing with the runner.
That is true. He can't tackle though. He can only walk over there.
You can't blitz. Well, am I literally just out of range?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You talking about Ninebeards by any chance?
He's talking about the one that's the nine. Captain Ninebeards that's engaged with the.
I'm confused as to why he didn't push him away like further.
I don't think Pete realized he was that close.
Yeah,
it's still really risky though.
I mean, let's be fair,
really risky, but it is an option.
Me deciding to stall another turn instead of dodging instead of scoring was the risky play to begin with.
Yep, there it is.
With the dice as well.
Them dwarves, mate. Them dwarves with that two... it was a three agi piece, to be fair.
Yeah, I guess it's a blitzer.
Yeah.
The blitzers and the runners are like the most dangerous pieces in this situation. Because they are actually way faster than you expected.
They are.
Just as fast as your beastman.
Very pretty much identical stat wise to beastman.
But the beastmen have horns, so.
That's not true, Ronnie. That one's that's not true, Ronnie. That one's slower than beastman. Beastman is 6. Blitz is a 5.
This is a 5? Oh, the runner's a 6 then.
Runner's a 6, yeah.
Oh, man.
Better dodging out of the way rather than blocking. Follow?
How about.
Is Pete finished pushing his luck?
No.
Fall over?
Yeah, I did the go for it.
just like run in and out of the tackle zone to be a dick. Like,
oh, I'm just running down the line. It's like, yeah.
And like, in the crowd, he's playing like, da 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 da.
I'll be honest, there was a real point on that drive where I thought I was going to lose it. I really did.
I was concerned when Greg like pushed that much distance into your half and you seemed very locked up, but you made the risky plays and you broke the ball out.
Yeah.
In the rain.
Yeah. In the rain.
In the bloody rain, yeah.
Like, that was... I wasn't expecting that, I'll be honest.
To be fair, that, like... Obviously, you don't want to be in such a sort of tied-up situation, but that is pretty much, like, how you play against the Dwarves. That was what I was saying you need to exploit their speed, but, like, and... When we were talking about, like, well, it's not necessarily one player, it's two players. Like, two players with a pass, like, you can just outrun the Dwarves so hard.
Just basically the Dwarves have to commit, like, what Greg did there was that he committed to, like, trying to get the ball and, you know, driving on his own. But he had then, like, pushed forward way too many Dwarves and committed a lot more than I think he expected you to get out of. So...
What is nice as well, you also managed to do it in... It, obviously, it got a bit dicey at the end, but you managed to do it in, doesn't give Greg 2 drives.
Yeah, I mean...
Well, like, you proper
can
drives.
He,
I mean,
can a
dwarf theoretically player a, possible for me to
yeah,
score?
Yeah, can a dwarf player so score in 2 turns?
Yes. You'll get it. You can't get a blitz, but you could get a quick snap.
It is so quick, theoretically possible.
Yeah, it runs, go for it.
You'd need go for it and a quick snap.
I don't need a quick snap.
No, but a quick snap would vastly help you.
Yeah, well, yeah.
It's a free square of extra movement.
Yeah, because you would be moving 25% of your maximum move value.
That's
a lot.
That's solid maths.
Yeah.
That's kind of depressing when you think about it.
You can move 1 square. Wow!
You've got a runner on the line, now, guys. One GFI to power him down.
No, I need 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Yeah, no, I only need 1. You're right.
All of our KO dudes actually get up on both sides. That's amazing.
All from that side are gone, and yeah.
I didn't even realize that Greg had an extra piece.
Why do you have an extra piece, Greg?
Because I have an extra guy. Because I had the guy out, didn't I? So I bought the extra
guy. Oh, so you just bought a new person, didn't you? Yeah.
But you didn't fire the niggle.
No, because he's a troll slayer. And I couldn't afford to buy a new one.
I could. So, I can't decide whether I want to just buy a 4th gutter runner or replace the niggled one. Because the niggled one does have block.
It's really tough. Hey, got a reroll.
That's a really shit. That is the furthest scatter possible.
Yeah, but it doesn't go, like, it's actually a pain for Greg to get it to who he wants to get it to.
Yeah, that's problematic.
Because he wants to get to the runner on the other side of the pitch.
Oh my god, that's a go for it, apparently. Right.
Grim Gary is like, well... The attacker
has an assist. Oh, I was really hoping we were about to get the classic dwarf walks up, gets smacked.
It would have been nice. That
stuff's Greg has to pick the ball up now, though.
This is true.
The armor breaks are real.
It's something like... The animations are nice, but the fact that there's no animation on a both down is great, because you just see them hit the floor and then roll over. Just thud.
Oh my god.
glad I stuck my beastman on that. If that had happened to three chaos warriors, I would not have been happy.
I mean, let's have a look.
Go one short.
It wouldn't have broken the armor if, at that one, at least.
Yeah.
The one before would have, because it was an 11, but that one would
have. The other two would have, because it was a 10 and an 11. Yeah. Alright, well, he broke a chaos warrior anyway, so it's not really the point.
Some damned good roll in there.
I mean, if you're going to go for a long bomb pass with dwarves, I mean...
YOLO, I'm alright.
Yeah.
God, this is the point where you intercept with the Minotaur. Come on, Pete, I believe.
He fails to pick up.
50%.
He fails again.
It's looking a bit
That makes it a little bit less likely. Still possible, but...
Just a bit more unlikely.
Probably should have moved the runner up this time.
Oh, the other runner.
Pick it up.
It's fine. That guy tactically fumbled it, so it's now within range of that runner.
Oh, yeah. It is.
Convenient. Calculated.
Tactical fumble right there.
Is this why I'm bad at dwarves? Because I don't have the tactical fumbles?
Yes. Greg has won a match up a tactical fumble, and this is setting up to win, to like draw up this match.
Man.
To be fair, Madden has also exploited tactical fumbles.
Oh, that's true. So did I at one point.
Luna. Oh, never.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, but, like, he's Mr.
That run is now just like, uh-oh.
He's fine. He can still dodge. He's got this.
He's got to make... He's got to make 4+ dodges as well.
He's got... I believe in him. I mean, it's... Yeah. It was a gambit. It was almost never going to pay off. But I figured I'd go for it anyway.
Oh yeah, why not? I would have done the exact same in your situation. Because you just have to like hope, right? Like, because you can't just go two turns, it's impossible, and
yeah,
then give
mean,
up.
Occasionally you have to pick the YOLO plays, let's be honest.
Yeah. That's how I got a score against Madden. Just by saying, fuck it.
YOLO players, the dwarves. I told myself at the start of this season that I would just be playing it to have fun. And so far, I have succeeded.
To be fair, I feel like it's definitely true.
I mean, it's a good start. It's a good start. I mean, were you out of rerolls?
He's out of rerolls.
Ah.
However, it is not the second part.
It's definitely true of fast teams, but I just think every team in general, like, if confident plays are stronger than they seem. Just having confidence in your play. Which is something I'm struggling with my orcs.
Yeah.
Gotta be willing to do
it's something I've definitely got better at in the last few games.
Yep.
Just being like, well, it's a gutter runner. He can totally make 2 GFIs.
I mean, let's be fair, yep. With your YOLO bouncing of balls everywhere and tossing it God knows where, you're doing quite well.
That was only one of them, and like, it wasn't that relevant to the outcome of the game.
You threw the ball across the enemy team several times, though.
You did. Oh, yeah. You threw it across my entire team at least twice.
Yeah, but only one of them gets to intercept, and it's a 6. Like,
yeah, but it's just a 1 in 6 of that pass just not happening.
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah, like, that one, I agree. Like, that would have had major outcomes on the outcome of the game. That one time it bounced around like 12 players.
That had massive outcome on the course of the game. What are you talking about? That put you, instead of Pete being 1-0 down, he was suddenly 2-0 down.
No, that put me at 3-0 up.
Well, it's still like an even bigger thing that does influence the outcome of the game.
Where's that going this time?
High kick.
Oh my gosh!
That's not too bad. That's not bad at all.
Well, we still got rain as well, so...
Oh shit, yeah. That was a 5+ to catch because of the rain. you survived the rain, Pete. You survived the rain.
You scored during the rain. Like, you'd been doing
I made a pass during the rain.
Yep.
Mm.
Not only in the rain, you made a pass during the rain where the guy who was the guy who was catching was in a tackle zone. So that's negative two.
Why was that a
five plus?
Because catching's harder.
Because he's at agility three, so it would take it from 67% to 50%.
Yeah, but it's minus one on catch rolls.
It's yes, so the minus one would go from a 3+ to a 4+.
But I think kicks.
It
like...
was a plus five. I've checked.
Yeah, it was. That's what I'm saying. Why was it a 5+ if it was an agility three in rain?
Because I think long I think kicks count as like long bombs or something. They're harder to catch. I've noticed some like catches like scatter. Like I'm pretty sure just loose balls. So like when a ball goes loose in a scrum or whatever, those are also minus one to catch as well. Because I've noticed like agi three pieces needing 50-50s to like grab them.
So like an accurate pass would be easier to catch.
I think so.
Totally makes sense.
I will double check the living rule book at some point, and yeah.
I mean, it's a 4+. Yeah, you know, it's 4+ because of the rain, and then yeah, 5+ because of the kick. Yeah. Well, he's got the ball, so we're not in the best of positions right now. I was hoping he might get stalled for a turn. I'll be honest.
The dwarves are setting up for the classic dwarven hammer down the middle.
Are we coming up with new words again, are we, Josh?
They're not new words. They're new tactics.
Special tactic.
Special tactics.
I miss White Rao.
Do you, though?
Yeah.
You need to get guard on Typo Nega Beast.
I need to get lots of things on lots of people, but it's not really going to happen if they're not going to level up, man.
Yeah, it's so sad that Minotaur's like got the 3 from that score in what your first game.
Yeah,
and then he just hasn't like gotten any SPP since the first game. That's just depressing.
Weren't you considering break tackle?
No, that was on my troll in the other team, the other game.
Oh,
yeah, because he was a thrower back then.
Still is a thrower.
Speaking of trolls, I'm probably going to buy a troll on my orc team, but not until after I played Ronith. Because I have enough money to do it right now, but if I did it right now, I'd give Ronith like 160k.
Yep.
Because he has the lowest team value in the league right now because he has 2 leveled up skinks out. So like his team value is 1,000.
120 plus because of...
For God's sake!
That is unfortunate
because
PU.
Of journeyman.
Boff.
Yeah,
Gosh.
But
team
what the
fuck?
Are you
serious?
Oh,
he nearly got KO'd too.
He nearly got KO'd.
Jesus. Does he have thick skull?
Yeah,
he does.
No, thick skull saved you.
Most big guys do.
Hello. That way, apparently.
In fact, yeah, I think...
Like, that was a smart play. It's just... once again, my dice hate me on defending my own drive.
Yeah, that was real unfortunate.
Greg's armor breaks are really stacking up.
To be
though.
Fair, he's had a fair few as well.
Like, not as not, I bet. I bet
not you, as many as this.
I bet
like,
you'll see on the end slate that you've had so many more armor breaks. So
contract
many more.
Contract armor breaks.
Contract armor breaks annoy
successful
me.
Successful blocks.
Yeah, and a successful block is a push. Anything where your player doesn't fall down, you can only
well,
track
that's
injuries.
That's why it shows you armor breaks though.
It does like, tell you armor breaks at the end.
Yep.
Tail
breaks.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Specific. Oh, Christ, man. I mean, I am getting
on. I can't deny that.
No,
you can't deny it.
I mean, you tried just now.
No. I'm not denying that I'm getting a lot, but he was also getting a fair few.
Not as many as this. You are constantly
this
stunning.
Is, I mean, this turn has stacked up.
You are constantly stunning at least 2 of my dudes a turn. Consistent.
It's a good time.
For you, yeah.
Yeah. Well,
and a stun. Oh.
I feel like Greg's only failed, like, a block in this team so far.
Yeah.
I guess, because...
I failed.
The one dice has happened real strong for Greg.
Yeah, like...
You only failed them both down. It's like... Oh, not even... Sorry, on an attacker down. It's like, oh my god.
Yeah, but like he doesn't even seem to get that many pushes. He seems to get the stumble and downs all.
Yeah.
Cheers, Greg.
It's alright. Anytime.
That's nice. Oh, cool. Your beastman leveled up.
Yeah, he's the one that made the
touchdown.
Touchdown, yeah.
Let's see if I can't push him off the field and kill him.
I don't think Pete would be happy about that.
I would, though.
You wouldn't get anything from it.
Yeah, but it would be funny.
It would be fucking depressing, is what it would be.
For you.
Dead. No.
For you!
It's not going to be dead, because I don't get arm breaks, remember?
And if you do, they're stunned. Admittedly, I don't think there's been no injuries this game, right? It's just been stunned.
Oh, and a couple of KOs.
Yeah, it's like three
KOs. No injuries just yet.
Some dwarves falling
and
over.
And dead. Oh.
You don't have the power run if you're just making it the opposite.
Keep doing it.
Well, I'm just going to keep saying dead then.
Why? Why would you empower Greg? Greg doesn't need your
Say it when he does it as well, it's fine.
Okay, fair enough.
If you could stop it altogether, that would be nice. Really no, nice.
You're all dead.
From that point on, no armor breaks in this game.
No armor breaks ever. Right, we'll all be happy friends.
Ryan turns Blood Bowl from interesting to dull as fuck. Nothing happens.
I will make a team called Push. Just push. I don't get any armor breaks. I just push people around and go like, yeah. No, go away.
It's really annoying that I had to really use that blitz to stop my fucking guy. Right next to a teammate. Three stubs around that cage really doesn't help either.
Like halflings round a sandwich. Like halflings round a sandwich.
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 Sounds like Sean Connery is in the bar. Like, hey, I would like a sandwich.
It's true. Sean Connery is watching this game from the VIP box.
Yes. He's like, that was a magnificent skull push.
God.
Every time the block comes up, I'm like, yes, and then I forget his dwarves.
Dwarves are bullshit.
The block has been very kind to Greg this season.
Yeah, like, Jesus.
Which you can't really complain about, because it's the main strength.
Yeah, it's just the strength of his team, but Jesus Christ, it is.
It just really shows off what a dwarf, like, what block does in Blood Bowl. It's a very strong skill.
Assume the Norse are here.
Slow progress that time.
Yeah, I can't wait for the Norse.
I want Norse!
Rodith, I have a horrible feeling, like, as much as you want Norse right now, and obviously I'm not going to definitely say this is true, I just have a feeling Norse are going to be one of those teams where you're like, yeah, I can't wait to fucking play Norse, and then you'll play, like, three games with them, and you're like, I fucking hate this team.
I hate Norse.
Well, I mean, that might happen. It's happened before. It's just, you know.
I really feel like they're not your kind of team. I'll just say that.
Well, maybe not.
Wow.
I don't mean it, like, in a negative way. I'm not trying to be mean. I'm just saying.
Jail.
Well, maybe not, but, like, they look awesome, and they seem awesome, so I don't know.
And
I have no idea. I've never played Norse before. It's a completely new team for me.
They're all armor 7.
Except Yeti.
I think the werewolf is also 8, actually, now I'm thinking about it.
I think all the Norse guys. Like
all I think all the dudes are 7, and then all the monsters are 8.
The fact that, like, that Longbeard down on the edge of the pitch, I just clicked on it to see his movement, and he can't even get out of the wide zone. It's hilarious.
Yep, 2 movement to stand up, and then you have an approximate 2 movement left. That's a reasonable amount of dwarfs on the floor.
Isn't it 3 moves to stand up?
Yeah. No, it's 2.
I think they can only walk one.
Oh, no, it is. You're right. Yeah, it is 3 to stand up. I always thought it was 2. Does mean a tree man has to make it going for it to stand up? Because they have
movement. Now?
2.
Well, yeah. Then, yeah.
You actually missed it earlier on. Josh?
So
basically, I had a look against my orc team, and I've got wood elves again next, and they've got plus movement on their tree man.
Oh my god! Maybe he doesn't have to do a go for it when he stands up.
No, he just hits zero. I guess that's an AI team. Yeah. I think that was just a fuck it YOLO from Pete.
He might fall over, but at least you get off the.
Yeah, I did that a lot in like the second, yeah. Like the later half of the season.
It's a completely reasonable move.
Yeah, if he stood up, it was an extra piece he'd have to allocate to try and knock down.
Yeah.
And it means he wouldn't have two die against the piece of him straight up as well.
Yeah, because the argument.
If I stood him up, he'd have two die against the beastman anyway, and then he'd be able to just move forward and push that attempt to push the fucking chaos warrior off the pitch.
Yeah, it's absolutely I think that move's fine because the argument obviously is well, now that dwarf's free, but like you weren't gonna stand that guy up on the edge of the pitch anyway, so that dwarf was gonna be free anyway.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, this turn's gonna be interesting.
Define interesting.
Depending on what happens here, you might have actually broken his cage.
No, it happened because he blitzes the miner.
With what?
Yeah, with what?
Don't give him.
My runner or
mob him with the runners.
Like he's going to struggle to clear this and actually form up a cage.
If you can't see it, I'm not going to tell you.
Yep.
Like
you've given him an idea now, though, Pete.
Yeah. let him waste the next minute figuring it out. I don't care.
I don't know what I could possibly...
I know the secret tactic. You have to hack the game to give you the Night Elf poison from the single-player campaign that
absolutely
gives your guys, like,
yeah,
stupid
that, that, that's
stats.
Exactly it, yeah. No, it flips stats around, so his AV...
It doesn't
becomes...
just flip them. It's like you get two stats worse and two stats better, but, like, yeah, the stats that are better are, like, significantly better. That campaign mission makes no sense.
Basically, all the dwarves' AV become their movement, and all their movement becomes their strength.
Oh, God.
I really don't know what I'd be doing here.
Well, giving me the ball would be a good start.
No, don't feel like...
In the red die.
Yeah, believe in the red die.
Why am I not surprised that that's your answer, Lucas? Oh, that double push.
You clear the way.
Dead.
Run, little fat man! Run!
Of course he fucking succeeds the dodge.
Yeah, but he can't defend that dwarf, really.
That's the problem.
Like, I saw that as a way to get the dwarf out, but it's like, you get to this position and it's like, there you can't really defend the dwarf.
Now what?
Cross fingers?
Yeah, pretty much.
Pretty much.
Like, what was it you were thinking I could do then?
I'm not telling him.
Well, why wouldn't you? It doesn't matter anymore.
Well, of course, it absolutely matters.
In what way? The ball is over there now.
Absolutely.
He could have blitzed the Mino for a red dice, but that was about it.
Like,
no, there wasn't. There was another play.
I mean, if he marked up.
Paradise. Oh my heart, there, Pete.
Oh Jesus.
I don't know why, but every time this Malitha attack was a dwarf, I'm just like, oh god, it's all over.
Yep, that's fucking annoying. Stupid dwarves and their...
And then...
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
I think Pete's probably fine with that.
Is there just a way around?
I'll side you four piece.
Okay. I think.
So one die for him. Right, yeah. And he gets a two die on that guy and then blitzes the runner. Oh, really? Okay.
I think I know what Pete's going to do.
A bit confused by what Pete's doing.
Yeah, I'm confused as why he didn't do what I was thinking of.
I Okay, that is not what I expected.
I would not have done that.
Yeah, well, you're not
Jesus
playing,
Christ, against block? Are you mad? Whoa. Oh.
Wow.
Jesus Christ, so many things happening now.
I like this ballsy play.
Yeah, it's
I'm really surprised. I'm gonna say no because I'm really surprised you didn't dodge out with the edgy four.
Yeah.
I'm confused as why he didn't use Judas Cheese to block Scurvy Stockley, thus freeing up that guy.
Yeah, I would have done the same with Sepultura.
Yeah, you could have
Sepultura
that guy.
Pushed out the Troll Slayer.
Celtic Toast doesn't even have 4 agility.
I'm guessing he wanted to set up the Agi 4 to actually pick up the ball. Which totally makes sense, actually, given
the
situation.
I do like the balls he plays, though, Pete.
Have to make him.
Yeah.
It's a bit sad that, like, the dwarves that are irrelevant are falling over. I'm almost mad, dude.
I would like to disagree with your...
Fuck! The last thing I needed to do!
Uh-oh.
The loner has failed you.
I'm not sure if, like, I can... Interesting.
He can definitely... He's a strength 4 dwarf. He's definitely gonna cause problems now.
Oh, definitely. It's just, interesting what will happen.
Actually, wait, is that relevant? So, no.
There's a thing I could do, which would be nice, but I don't think it helps.
I don't actually think that strength 4 dwarf being free is relevant.
Not right now, at least.
Yeah, not right now. Because he could do blitzes, but I feel like Greg needs to blitz other things.
Yeah.
I think I know what I'm gonna do, but it's.
I wonder if you're going to do what I think you're going to do.
Unpleasant. Risky.
Either way, you need to do at least one dodge.
Not necessarily.
That is a valid point. I didn't think about that one. That was the one thing I didn't think of.
That's what I was thinking.
Me as well.
All over. I mean.
Okay. Always score with go for it. So I don't think I've ever scored without a go for it.
You gotta do it, man.
I don't think it's. I think that's actually true, yeah.
You gotta do it, Dwarves, man.
Oh, God. Jesus.
But, four turns. Still entirely possible for Pete.
I've robust the score.
Yeah.
Far more likely for him to score, but I could.
Because I mean, you could have scored it. You could have scored in 4 last time, right, Pete? It's just you stalled for like 2 more.
Yeah.
It's really funny, Greg, how you have 3 rerolls, but you never use them all.
Thanks for that.
Quick snap. Oh, that's good.
Never have to.
Yeah, that's because he has so many skills. Like,
yeah, like having them doesn't. Like, I make plays so that I don't have to use them, which is obviously the...
How you should play Bubble.
Yeah. But then I have them as a backup.
And exactly. That's literally what they're for.
Whenever anything goes wrong, I have a reroll.
It's just interesting, like, because I can't really say, like, oh, maybe you should sell one of them for, you know, not in the inflating your... Your team value. But then again, having 2 is like still.
I think 3 is perfectly fine.
3 is fine. It's just, you know.
Oh,
wow.
Come on. Oh.
Right, cool. Fuck's sake.
Oh, you only got 1. Oh, you don't have any. Oh, God.
Say, I think 3 is something fine, so, because, like last season, at the end of the season, I was on 3 with my elves, and like there were a few games where I full halves without ever using any of them, but I still like kept them because there were a couple of games where it was like I used all of them in a half, even with the advanced skills and shit I had. So,
yeah.
It's like
I'm totally agreeing that 3 is a good number.
Absolutely gonna get fucked by dice now.
You've been You've been fucked by dice for a while now.
If you could hold it at a 1-1, that'd probably be a good result for you.
I'd like to win. A win would be nice.
Would like the win.
But I'm just... I mean, it's definitely possible for you to still score. It's just obviously it gets a bit hairy when you don't have the skills or rerolls at this point. And it's still raining.
Yeah, it hasn't stopped raining, despite nice weather being like the most common outcome.
Like, the rain doesn't bother me, like, so much.
I wish it had I wish there was a blizzard. That's funny.
Blizzards are hell.
What does it do again?
Yeah,
this is to be Greg's nemesis.
Going for it, you fail on a 1 or a 2.
No, God.
Whoa!
and also, you can't throw the ball over a medium pass, I think?
Yeah, you can't.
Yeah.
Long pass or Hail Mary.
Yeah, like, Josh, those impossible go-for-its just became, like...
Literally double as hard?
Literally, like, trying to get out of a black hole difficulty.
Mm-hmm, pretty much. Blizzards are pretty rough. They are funny though. I'm trying to think, there's the sweltering heat, there's rain and blizzard. Is there another thing?
Sweltering heat, rain, blizzard.
Nice.
Really sunny.
It's marginally sunny, but not sweltering.
Oh yeah, really sunny.
Really,
yeah.
Really sunny.
I always forget really sunny and sweltering.
The contrasty.
Hot contrast increase. Yeah.
Yeah.
The thing you don't notice until you.
It doesn't help that the icon is like basically the same as well.
Yeah, it is. It's like
kill,
die.
Oh my god!
God, the number of armor breaks you've had. Not got an injury with that guy.
There's been no injuries in this entire game.
No, I mean specifically that Minotaur has had a lot of armor breaks. Just nothing to give him SPP.
Yeah. It's very, very true.
At least he's not dugging it up for the most part.
Yeah.
Not gonna lie, Pete, every time you make these blocks, and I know you have to make them, and I don't disagree with you making them, but my butt is clenched every single time.
The big ace this season has been really well behaved.
Yeah, it's...
Your ogre.
Your ogre is just a...
Yeah.
Yeah, but the rat ogre as well.
No, the red ogre's been schizophrenic. It's just when he is doing things, the things he does, it's just insane.
Yeah, and then he just goes, duh. I'm gonna stand here for a while. My guy just fucking hit himself.
Yeah, I'd actually say the worst big guy this season has been the Crocs.
Yeah, but he's been pretty useful though, so.
Yeah, he's been
just
reasonable.
Like last time.
He was like the only big guy last time. There was a dwarf. There was a troll, and that was
still
it.
The worst one.
Yeah. The thing is, you gotta love him, or you know they're not
no
perform for you.
I tried loving him. Didn't
no,
work.
You didn't. Apparently, you didn't. Well, evidently.
You just knew that deep down inside, I couldn't fight the hatred.
Oh, come on.
Right.
At least the rain didn't make it worse.
Looking
at the bright side of things.
Rain. Makes everything miserable.
My fucking rolls are making me miserable.
Yeah, that was the fail without rain. He rolled a 1 and he had no rerolls.
How much cash do you have, Pete? Do you have anything?
70 or 80?
So you can probably get a reroll after this game.
Well, really depends.
That's true. Because I have noticed a lot of your players hampered by the rerolls. Again, not blaming you.
It's the same as orcs.
Yeah.
You took hold of the ball like an over.
I can't pick up the ball with a 3 plus. Are you? Oh my fucking Christ!
Never lucky.
Always lucky.
Never. A quote, Greg, 2016, hashtag never lucky.
Hashtag sometimes lucky.
God.
Hashtag massive cock muncher.
Yeah,
I agree with that hashtag.
Cannot disagree with
like,
that.
You literally, like, I swear to God, it's probably just mental bias, but I swear to God, in this entire tournament, Greg has owned, like, Greg has had like two.
I think I failed like two. Yeah.
Yeah, no, like I, two. I don't... Like it's just consistent yeah, right. Both downs that you just don't give a fuck about.
This is once again unlikely to pan out well for me. Never
see where the ball goes first.
Yeah, never lucky. Never lucky.
All right.
It never happened. Never.
So there are essentially two plays right
Come
now.
Come on! It's a three plus! Come on!
Why are you moving that guy first? There's like
because
a
he's the...
He wants
four
to pick
agility
up the ball.
Pace to pick up the ball, Ronith. Then he makes the pass to the other Chaos Warrior. Then the other Chaos Warrior runs down the field. That's what the play was. But apparently, I can't make a 3+ to pick up the fucking ball.
It's okay. He can't score.
It's depressing that I can't score. Never lucky.
Oh, yeah. Can't score. All
this
right.
Game is a draw.
Can't score.
Yep, it's a draw.
I'm 2 squares out.
No, you're 1 square out.
You're 1 square out.
Hmm? Oh, shit, yeah.
It doesn't matter. You'd have to make dodges and shit with that guy to even make it to 1 square out.
That wouldn't stop me, as we've seen in the past. But yeah, less likely. Get some SPP. Come on, break some guys.
This has been a really low SPP game.
Mine always fucking
given the amount of brutalizing.
What brutalizing? There's been no injuries.
That's what I mean, but like, there's been just so many punches and stuff.
Considering the armor breaks is what
you should considering the armor breaks, but... Like, what's it like... Right now, it's literally just... Only you got a pass. So it's
yeah,
9,
I have 1,
eight?
I have one more SPV.
9-8,
I was thinking, yeah.
And this Greg can, like, do a YOLO pass. Now. Oh my god, he failed the... There we go.
No, there we go. He has those 3
Life.
Rerolls.
3 rerolls. Turn 16.
Jesus.
It's not that obscene.
Pretty obscene.
It's not that obscene.
Had to use
it. There are several other players who have not had to use rerolls.
Yeah. Like I said, my elf team last season, I had multiple games where I didn't use a reroll and a half.
Got an injury. Damn it. Right. That was a game.
The game is still on.
Yeah, he can
the
still injure me. But
still happens.
The game is now out of my hands.
Yep.
And before, like, every block Pete does now kills a dwarf.
Well.
Die.
Rooney.
Start again, I guess. New team.
You can't start again, it's a league, Greg. God, just
use loners. I don't use my rerolls anyway.
Fuck me. That'd be kind of funny.
Just a team of entirely loners.
That'd be so depressing.
You sure you can't play when you have that many loners.
No, you can have an entire team of loners. As long as it's not the first game of the season.
Yep.
Jesus.
The team value would be real low.
Yeah, it'd be zero.
Yeah.
I mean, it would be inflated by a lot of things.
It'd be zero, and then 11 times whatever your loner journeyman.
Yeah, what is your...
Well, no, I've got re-rolls and stuff, right? So
that's true.
That's
true,
yeah.
It's like...
I can't think of anything worse than playing with 11 loners. 11 loner linemen would be the grimmest
That's
thing.
Fine. Again,
yeah, I can think of something worse.
11
with, I was going to say, well, no, 11 treatment would be pretty bad, but I was going to say 11 loner Bretonian linemen.
Would be pretty bad.
And everyone has animosity.
Oh, God.
And everybody has bloodlust.
Well, no, because at least the Bretonian linemen would have Fend. Whereas everyone else would have no skills, apart from dwarves, obviously.
Wow.
God, I'm
roll higher than a 2, apparently.
No.
Long
I cannot pick the ball.
Well, that was a game.
Oh, you got another level up.
I haven't seen where the MVP goes. I would have hoped I got another level up with the Esprit.
Niggle the Troll Slayer also.
Yeah, Niggle Troll Slayer leveled up.
Yeah.
And Judas Cheese leveled up.
Yes.
That was a very low HP game.
There was only 10 to 7 armor breaks.
Really felt like the dwarves were getting more. I guess the dwarves just had groups of them more, whereas you got like one every other turn.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. I really wasn't getting that many more. At all.
They felt more impactful though.
Yeah, I was getting like 3 a turn every few turns.
That's the first time I've seen
like
no injuries inflicted.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah. GG, Greg.
GG. Good game.
And until next time, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much to all the co-commentators and to Greg. And until the next video, ladies and gentlemen, we'll see you next time.